Today, I am so excited for this video. Today, we're going to be talking about how to actually get rich from trading Forex. And I'm not joking around. I'm not giving you some sort of clickbait. This is my genuine, absolutely honest answer on how to actually get rich for real in Forex trading. It is possible. It is something I believe that you can do. And it is something that I am trying to do with my own trading through this method that I'm about to talk to you guys about. So trading Forex, as we all know, can be a very lucrative business. If you catch the right moves, if you have the right strategies, you can make big money from Forex. There are some things to think about though. It's not easy money and it's not gonna come like that, right? It's gonna require some things that you need to do in order to actually become consistently profitable, number one, and actually to grow a serious amount of wealth, number two. There's a couple things we need to talk about. The first thing we need to talk about is, of course, you need a strategy, right? You need a concept, whether you're trading pullbacks, whether you're trading breakouts, it doesn't really matter exactly what your strategy is, but you need to be able to A, do it consistently, right? Do it well. And number two, actually have some sort of edge, meaning that the more you trade, the more you make over time, right? A lot of traders, they put all their money in on one trade or two trades, trying to double and triple very quickly, when the reality of successful trading is many trades compounding and building an account over time. But today, what we're talking about is how to actually, in the grand scheme of things, get wealthy, get really wealthy from trading Forex. And I do believe it is possible. Let's dive into this concept. So we have this kind of calculator that I'm going to pull up here. This, again, is my genuine 100% honest approach to what it would take to get rich trading Forex for a living, for a career. It is something that I think is possible, but we need to do a little bit of calculations. There's a little bit of work that we need to do here, so let's go ahead and talk about this. If you have a small amount of money, it is definitely going to be harder for you to build a large amount of money from your trading. The more money you have at the start of your trading, considering that you would have a good strategy and you're actually a consistent trader, the more money you can actually end up standing to make from your trading and from your investing. So if you have $100,000 and you make 1%, clearly that's going to be a lot more than if you have $100 and you make 1%. So capital is clearly a part of it. But what if you don't have a ton of capital right now, but you still have the dream of being a full-time trader and you have the dream of building a massive amount of wealth from your trading? Is it still possible? Well, I think we could do some calculations and we could answer the question for ourselves. First, you need to answer one important question though. What percentage can you actually do on a consistent basis per year or per month, right? For example, can you do plus 5% per year? Well, a lot of people would say it's easy. Granted, most people lose money, so 5% is actually very difficult compared to the masses to do. But can you do something like 10%? Can you do something like 15%? What about 20% per year? Can you do this not once, not twice, but consistently for the long term? If you're a short-term trader and you can make 20% per year, that is actually fantastic and long term will serve you very, very well. Stay with me here. So what we're going to do is we're going to do a little calculation. Let's assume for the kind of giving it the benefit of the doubt that you can make 20% per year. Let's say that you learn your stuff. You are seriously devoted to trading Forex. You're getting good and you're able to make a solid 20% per year without fail. Well, that's what we're gonna need for this calculation. So let's say that, okay, well, you have 20% per year that you're able to make. Well, let's say that your initial contribution, how much money is in your account at the start of this time, right? Remember, we're trying to make 20% per year. That's our goal. How much money are you starting with? This money really, really does matter. Because remember, it's gonna compound, and that's the point of having this compound growth calculator. So let's say that you have $10,000, okay? A lot of people might have more than this, a lot of people have less than this. So if you have $10,000, I feel like that's a pretty middle of the line trading package or a middle of the line trading account size. That is actually not that much to be trading with, depending on where you are in the world. Granted, if you're in the US, that's not that much. If you're in another country, that might be a lot to you. And I'm not saying that. It really comes down to your own financial situation and where you are in the world. But for in the US, $10,000 to kind of the average household is really not that much money. So let's say that you have $10,000. And let's say that you don't make any contributions. Well, again, let's put our number in. 20% per year would be considered very good on this calculator. You can see almost at the top there. 20% per We're not going to contribute anything, so this doesn't matter for now. Compounding frequency, we're going to compound annually. Okay, so our goal, remember, is 20% per year we're going to try to make on this Forex account. Okay, well, let's say that we do this for 5 years. What's our amount going to be? We can scroll down and you can see, take a look here. What do we have? There's our initial $10,000. At the end of our compounded gains, we had $14,883,000 in gains, okay? The account now is at nearing $25,000. Well, in the US, this would be very hard to live off of. You couldn't live off of, and more importantly, you couldn't reinvest your gains if you were living off that money, right? If you made all this money and you were just using it, then you're just burning it and it goes away. Well, that's really not what we want to do. The power of trading and investing is that you can compound it over time. So, you know, $10,000 trying to live off of it is going to be a very difficult task. But let's talk about another kind of scenario that maybe more people could commit to. Let's say that you still have $10,000. We won't change that. But what if we were able to add $500 from our paycheck, from our livelihood, from our business, whatever we're doing, to our trading every single month? Okay, if we could add $500, take a look at the difference here, guys. This is the big power of compounding gains. Okay, well, we have $500 being added, and let's say we still do 20%. Look at the difference. Look at the difference in our 5-year span. Our $10,000 is up to $73,491. That is a crazy, crazy difference. And all we did was commit to adding $500 to the account every single month. Okay, we're not withdrawing, we're not taking a bunch of money out like they all do on social media, right? They claim every time they make $1,000, they're like, I'm gonna pull this out and go party with it. That's not what we're doing. We're doing the opposite. We're taking our wins, we're taking our progress, redepositing it in and compounding it and using money for what I believe is the true power of money, which is to make more money, okay? So what you can see here is that with that $500 difference, 5 years of time, that's a serious, serious kind of growth, right? So, but notice we contributed $40,000 of that $73,000. So it is kind of, you are kind of tongue in cheek, right? Where you're depositing a lot of money along the way. But the power here is that a lot of people can commit to something like $500 per month or something like that, especially in the US, right? People could potentially, especially if you have two income sources in a household, right? That's possible to be doing those plus $500 deposits along the way, okay? So again, this is, remember, contributing $500 and doing a 20% per year return. That's a very high return in the world of finance and investing, and not easy to do, okay? So that is some caveat, but what if we get to a different level with it? What if we continue to work really hard at our job, and let's say that you had something like $50,000 to trade, which a lot less people have, but you know, it's still, a lot of people would be able to start with that amount of money. And let's say that if you have that sort of income per month, let's say that you up it to, let's say you could deposit $1,500 to your account. This is a little bit more aggressive, but here's the thing, guys. This is where you start to get to the point where, okay, now you are talking potentially living off of your trading by doing this. You're still making 20% per year. Let's say you do this for 5 years and we're making $1,500 contributions every month. Let's say you have a good job or you have a good other sources of income, business, whatever, right? You do odd jobs, whatever you're doing, you deposit $1,500 to your trading account on top of your initial $50,000 per month. Well, take a look here. Now we're looking at some different numbers. This is actually really kind of crazy. So now we're at $270,000 in the trading account after 5 years. Granted, we deposited $140,000. We'd have to be working that whole time depositing. But remember, a lot of people, they're looking for trading to be an easy way out for them. But remember, when you go to school for something, as I went to school for computer science, I spent 4 years and a lot of money getting my degree in computer science and programming, right? So 4 years down the drain, not really. I mean, I learned a lot from it, but I spent a lot of money on that and I didn't really get anything in terms of immediate value out of it. I got an education, which is to some degree valuable. But in this case, you have to understand, you have to treat it in a similar way. I'm depositing, I'm putting money down in the hopes of my future being more positive. And the power here of Forex trading is if you can do good returns, if you get your trading skills up and you have that serious, you know, good returns over years and years of effort, that's where things can change for you dramatically. Imagine if 5 years from today, you started doing this. You started, you know, 5 years from today, you had been doing this all along. Your life would be very, very different. It would be a very different financial situation for you, whatever this number is. So again, in this case, we're up to 270,000, but let's say we take it one step further just for the fun of it. Let's say that you have $100,000 to trade. Of course, this is going to be a lot less people than the initial talk. But if you have $100,000 of contribution, which again, in the US is actually, it's more rare for sure, but it's still possible. There are households that could potentially do this. This would be definitely on the riskier side for a lot of people, but some people have this kind of money. And let's say that you were able to do $2,500 deposits. $2,500 deposit monthly, we have $100,000 initial, and let's stick to our 20% per year. 5 years, look at this number. Now we're talking about something to a whole different degree. Our $100,000, we deposited $250,000 along the way, and now we're up to nearing $500,000 in this trading account. Well, really quick, guys, let me show you this. Let's say that at the end of those 5 years, you decide, okay, well, you know what? I'm gonna go one step further. I'm gonna take all the money I just made from this trading, and I'm going to, at this point, let's say you have $5,000 to add. Now, look at this. This is really crazy. So if you did that for 5 years and you had $500,000 roughly in your trading account, of course there's taxes along the way and there's things that you would have to give back on the way. But just assuming for the sake of our calculation here, look at this number. Our $500,000 account, 5 more years, so this is 10 years from our initial start date, could potentially be up worth $1.7 million. Now, this is where the power of trading and investing is, in my opinion, is not in today, not in tomorrow, not in 1 week, doubling and tripling accounts, as they all say they do on social media. The real power of trading and investing is that multiple years, multiple, actually really even lifelong journey of trading and investing and compounding money so that your compound growth looks like this, and that, you know, you let your money work for you. And this is what so many people in our generation and now in our society are doing today, is they want money now. They want the serious life-changing stuff to happen overnight. And the reality is that the power of trading and investing is not just in the Y coordinate, right? How much money you can make. The power really comes from also the X coordinate, which is time. The power is in the patience. The power is in the discipline and the approach. If you could do 20% per year for years and years, that's where you're going to seriously make a difference in your financial lifestyle. So one more thing to add here, some people are crazier than this. Let's say that you could make 30% on average. At this point, your money would just, it doesn't even go there. It doesn't even go to 30% on this calculator. If you could do 25%, you're at $2 million. That's crazy, guys. And you know, there are traders out there who can do nice numbers like this over the years. And that's where the real power comes from, is being able to consistently make large consistently make a decent amount of return and grow that account into a large account over time and continue to use money for what, again, my personal opinion is to make more money. That's the power of money. This is just a little bit of a fun experiment. I hope you guys got something out of this video. Do me a favor. If you liked the video, then give a like down below on the video and subscribe to the channel if you want more trading content here on YouTube. I hope you got something out of it. Make sure to come back and see us again. Thanks very much. We'll see you next time.